For my next video, I'd like to do one on a product called the Radiacode, and this is their version 110. I've done other videos for this to give you a background on it. It is a Geiger counter slash spectrograph, and it not only detects radiation, but it will tell you what sort of radiation that is. In other words, uranium, plutonium, etc., etc. So it's really a Geiger counter on steroids, as they would say. And it detects not only, like I said, the important things. It's not just a clicker that clicks to tell you, yeah, you have a radioactive source, but after enough time, it will tell you what that source is. So let's just go ahead, and I'm going to change the screen over to the Radiacode. So this is normal background dose right now. I'm getting right here is 10.13 counts per second. Okay. I've had this going for 8 minutes, 37 seconds. I have, and I'll put a photo in the description. I'm going to put this on these, which I will take a picture of, thoriated tungsten rods. They're welding rods, but they're not really, really hot as far as radioactivity is concerned. They're fairly light, but it's a good example. And again, I want to specify, I'm far from a nuclear scientist. I do this as a hobby for fun. So if I make any mistakes or errors, it's possible. But I try to research all the things that I say and do on my video. So let's go ahead. So as you can see, it's around 8 to 10 to 10.8 now. And this is called 10.3. This is called background radiation. So you can see here, background radiation. The top one is 10.9 counts per second. So of those counts per second, we have 62, 81, 95 sieverts per hour, but they're nano sieverts. So that's a millionth of a sievert. 2 sieverts is lethal. So you can just see how slight the radiation is. But this is just background. This is just sitting here in my living room with nothing radioactive that it's touching. So let's go ahead. I'm going to put it on the thoriated rods, and the Geiger counter is definitely working, and it went up to 40, and it's at about 740 nanosieverts total. So next we have a spectrum, and let me just go over this because it's not been enough time. They say you need about 1 to 2 hours to get this spectrum set correctly. So each radioisotope has different peaks and valleys. Okay, so each one is making your own signature to whatever that item is. So as this continues on, you'll see the gray area is not finished yet. It's like painting a picture. It's not done yet. So we're at only 8 minutes and 40 seconds. So this can take all the way up to 1 to 2 hours. This is the new Radiacode 110. So they had the 101, 102, 103, and I'd be interested to see how fast this takes to get the picture. And when it's done, here is the picture that you'll see. So you can see thorium, and you'll see the valleys and the peaks. So you have Kelvin electron volts. So 1588, 911, 583, and 238 Kelvin volts is what we're looking for. So when you go to Radiacode's website, you'll see thorium. Then you'll see main emission lines, 238, 338, 583, 7, 911. It'll tell you all the Kelvin electron volts that match that particular isotope. So we have thorium again, and it's the Radiacode has a complete library of practically everything. I don't know if there's anything even missing on here, but it tells you all about it. It's a extremely long half-life, which means 14 billion years from now, it will be emitting half of what it is right now. So I don't think we'll probably be here. So it says making it nearly as old as Earth itself. The TH-232 undergoes alpha decay, eventually leading to a series of decay products that form the thorium decay series. So there's alpha. I'm not a nuclear scientist, so I'm going to touch so briefly on this that you could get this out of any two-year-old's handbook. There's alpha, beta, and gamma radiation. The alpha and beta can be stopped by just about anything. Paper on alpha, cardboard on beta. Gamma rays go right through everything, right through concrete, right through, and depending upon what it is, depends on how strong it is. So again, the thorium we're looking for is currently, it's not really red yet, because see at the top here, right now it's saying, well, we'll just go to this peak here. It's saying that that's, what is it saying? It's saying that's thallium, and I need thorium. So I'm pretty sure, see, thorium is 232, thallium is 208. So it's getting close, and I've only had it on there now for 8 minutes, 42 seconds. So it's getting very close. Another really neat thing you can do with this is you can do a background radiation. So you can let it sit there, get a background radiation. Then you can take and overlay this on top of what your background is, and you can see the differences. And I haven't done just a background radiation yet, so maybe I'll do my next couple ones. I've got some fairly spicy radioactivity items. I'll do some spectrum on those and show you the differences in just a background to this, which takes some time. But as you can see, this is all pretty self, to a degree, pretty self-explanatory. There's a whole lot here, though, to learn. And I'm still really in learning phases, so you can overlay. Let's see, I can't do anything now because I'm in typing mode here. Hang on, let me get out of this. Okay, no, it's not letting me. That's okay. So anyway, that's a real basic way of how to get a reading with your Radiacode. And you can hear it. Let's see if I can turn this on. I have the counter actually in my hand, so you can't see it. But as you can hear it ticking. And then when I go on to a hot item, like this, it'll set alarms off at a given rates and do all kinds of stuff. So you can make maps, you can do all kinds of stuff with this, which I'm getting way ahead of myself, but this is just a basic on some of the things this can do and how you detect and get a really basic first out of the box detecting of an item. So we'll be doing more videos on this soon. There's a lot to learn on this, and I'm going to do as much as I can. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Thank you for your time. And until next time, I'm out.